friends. Come forward, friends. Step forward. I bring you a message. A message few of you will be able to believe. A message of great importance. A message I alone was able to read in the fires of the universe.
I am the chosen one.
But be not afraid, my friends. I also bring you the means with which to save yourselves.
Save us from what?
From the end of the world, friend. Which I don't expect you to believe. But the rest of you, those who want to be alive tomorrow morning, I will tell you tonight. Remember that. Bring your friends here. I'll tell you tonight so that you will be able to prepare.
What are you selling, Mr. Snake Oil?
Take me in, O tender woman. Take me in, for heaven's sake. Take me in, O tender woman. Sighed the vicious snake.
The world will come to a flaming end at midnight tonight. Without my help and knowledge, every one of you will be dead.
But instead of saying thank you, that snake gave her a vicious bite. Take me in, O tender woman. Take me in, for heaven's sake. Take me in, O tender woman, sighed the vicious snake. I saved you, cried the woman. And you've bit me, heavens why. You know your bite is poisonous. And now I'm going to die.
You ought to keep riding, mister. Why? Just order, that's all. Comes midnight tonight, this whole town's gonna be dust.
And deplete a considerable amount of their nuclear arsenal. But this strategic advantage also highlights the Minuteman III's disadvantages. America's land-based Minuteman III's are inherently vulnerable, as their location is commonly known, and therefore silos can and will be easily targeted. As a result, in the event of a large-scale attack, the president would be put in a sticky situation. He or she would have to either use these 400 missiles or lose them, forcing a large-scale retaliatory attack in response to perceived incoming warheads targeting American silos. With enemy missiles already in flight, the leader of the free world would only have 15 minutes to decide. And once a missile is launched, there's no turning back.
Nothing but rocks and dust. Go ahead and laugh. Everybody else is. Everybody. Morning. Cup of coffee, please.
Right away. Anything else?
No, thank you.
Staying long?
Well, no, I just riding through.
Mm-hmm. Law?
Yeah. Tell me something. What's going on in this town anyway? Did your mayor die or what?
World's coming to an end.
How's that?
Midnight tonight, the whole caboodle's gonna burn up.
Oh. Where'd you get that?
Fellow back there.
With the one with the hat on?
Mm-mm. Other one.
He says the world is going to come to an end?
Midnight tonight.
Where's he from?
Drove in this morning. Wagon out front.
Mm-hmm. Got a name?
Trump.
How about...
Stop up their ears. He's supposed to give us the whole story tonight.
Well, I don't believe I'll wait till then. Excuse me.
But folks back there think differently.
Well, do they know what's going to happen?
Oh, some of them. They've been told.
Yes, sir. Good morning.
Mike.
Well, we got a ranger with us. How are you? I'm Sheriff Farrell.
Obi Gilman.
Something special bring you down here?
I'm on my way back to Porter.
Oh, I heard they sent for somebody. Too bad about the sheriff down there.
Well, has something happened to him?
He died.
Well, would you care to join us, Mr. Gilman?
Yeah, that's right. Thank you.
Planning to remain in town for long?
Well, I understand I have until midnight.
And you heard?
Yeah, I heard. Your name is Trump?
Dr. Walter Trump. D-U-M-C-S-S-R.
Oh, that's a whole bunch of letters.
Just a few of the degrees that have been conferred on me.
Would you mind, run through them again for me?
D.U. is Doctor of Universe. M.C. Master of Cometry. S.S.R. Student of Stellar Reactions.
Well, how do you figure that the world is going to end?
Well, that's really quite simple. According to my calculations, tonight, November 14th, the Earth will either collide with or come into close proximity to a comet. In any event, the outcome will be disaster. A cosmic explosion will end all. But the end may come by other means.
Now, how do you see it?
By means of this. Uncounted millions of these. This is a meteorite. Iron ore from out of space. They will rain on the Earth like pepper on an egg. Each one red hot, traveling at speeds in excess of millions of miles an hour. Molded by their passage into unstoppable bullets.
But you can stop them, huh?
I can, sir. And I will. See, they are drawn to the Earth by a force that we call gravity. I have discovered how to repel that force. By doing that, I can save this town.
Well, how?
By means of a force repeller.
You sell these force repellers?
You have a very suspicious mind, sir.
All right, Sheriff, how long are you going to put up with this?
What do you mean?
How long are you going to let this con man walk around town?
Be careful, son. I can sue you.
How about it, Sheriff? When are you going to put the lid on?
What for?
Well, stealing is stealing, whether you do it with a gun or a mouthful of mealy words.
I don't intend to sit here and be insulted, Sheriff. If your people don't want my help, I can go elsewhere.
Now, wait a minute, Mr. Trump. You don't talk for the rest of us. Can you prove he's wrong?
Well, no, not right now, but if you give me some time...
Well, that's something we don't have very much of.
According to him.
Yeah, well, let me tell you something. Right now, it's a lot safer to go his way than it is yours.
Well, how did you get to be sheriff?
Look, this is not a suggestion. It's an order. Move on.
Obi didn't know what Trump's pitch was going to be. He was sure of one thing. It was going to cost the people of Talpa. Since the sheriff wouldn't stop Trump, Obi had to find somebody who would. Sheriff Chet Farrow was the gun law in Talpa, and Judge Clement was the book law. It was to the judge that Ranger Gilman now turned.
Yes, Judge Clement?
That's right.
My name is Obi Gilman. I'd like to talk to you.
Well, come on in. Sit down. Thanks, sir. Can I get you anything?
No, thank you, sir.
You hear about Trump?
Yes, sir. What are you going to do about him?
What do you want me to do?
Stop him.
From what?
From taking the town.
Can you prove that that's what he has in mind?
Well, it's obvious.
But can you prove it? In order to arrest him, the sheriff has to have a charge. And Trump hasn't given him a thing to go on.
What side are you on?
The law? Oh, I know how you feel. Maybe I agree with you. But the law is the law. It's got to be kept.
What if I take him?
On what charge?
Fraud.
Don't you see? He's not exactly guilty of fraud.
Well, what about the meteors and the comet and all whatnot?
You might not like it, Mr. Gilman, but he's right. There could be a meteor rain tonight. The Leonids are due.
The what?
The Leonids. It's a shower of meteors. There's a book about it around here someplace if you want to look at it.
No, thank you, sir. I'll take your word for it. But...
Look here, son. I live here. I know these people pretty well. And right now, there's nothing in the world could change their minds. And anybody who tries to could end up getting hurt. They're not going to listen.
Well, what if he starts a panic? It could happen.
Events in Washington have taken a violent and tumultuous turn in the past few hours, as thousands of supporters of President Trump stormed the U.S. Capitol building, venting their anger at the victory of Joe Biden in the presidential election. They forced the evacuation and lockdown of Congress itself, where lawmakers were all set to approve the election result. Shortly before the clashes, President Trump had addressed his supporters near the White House, telling them that he would never accept defeat.
The peaceful transfer of power, the cornerstone of American democracy, seemed a highly abstract concept today, as Trump supporters clashed with police as they tried and succeeded to storm the Congress, where America's elected leaders had gathered to certify the election victory of Joe Biden.
Sure. You might as well try to spit out a forest fire.
Well, there's got to be some way to stop him.
Well, if there is, I don't know it. It's a funny thing.
Sir?
When we were kids, we were all afraid of the dark. And we grew up, and we weren't afraid anymore, but it's funny how a big lie can make us all kids again.
Hobie had checked the town. The people were ready to believe. Like sheep, they ran toward the slaughterhouse. And waiting for them was the high priest of fraud.
So coming out of this dream, this once of the shaman told me that actually the best thing happened in this planet right now is the Trump to be the president. I said, how is this possible? It's the best thing to happen. He said, yes, because he's so irrational. He's so crazy. That's actually create that awakening, that we finally wake up. Because before it would be another guy, and everything looks similar. But he's so different than anything else. So actually, he's the magician who waking us up. What do you think about that? That kind of theory.
I am the only one. Just me. I can build a wall around your homes that nothing will penetrate.
What do we do? How do we save ourselves?
You ask, how do you build that wall? You ask... And I'm here to tell you. This is your saving. This is your wall.
You mean that thing is going to save a whole town?
Don't laugh, friend. Please don't laugh.
Remember, you know, we took care of a lot of people, including, I guess, on December 21st, we took care of Joe Biden. Because he got his shot. He got his vaccine. He forgot. It shows you how unpainful that vaccine shot is. So everybody go get your shot.
It works incredibly well, 95%, maybe even more than that. It works incredibly well. And I would recommend it to a lot of people that don't want to get it. And a lot of those people voted for me, frankly. But yeah.
It's the markings. It's the magnetic force that is called up by these markings that will care for your loved ones.
How about our cattle? You got something for them?
They have not been forgotten. This is a very rare metal, friends. Mined by ancient Indian women in the heights of the Andes Mountains. It's in Peru, South America. Then it's taken to the secret smelters of old Montezuma. where it's refined and compounded until it becomes magnetium, the embryonic source of the universe. The force repeller is for you, and this little disc, by its mere presence, will care for your animals.
How can we get one of those?
I understand your anxiety, my friend. The thought of death falling from above is not a pleasant one.
You're a liar, Trump. You're a liar, Trump. You're a liar, Trump. There's not going to be any rain of fire.
Can you deny the meteorites will come? Can you deny the comet?
Well, it's not going to happen the way you say it is.
If it were not for my magnetium, friends, those meteorites would be bombarding us this very instant.
There, I saw one.
There's another one. They're all over the place. Man, it's a fake. There's nothing up there. You're seeing what you want to see. There's nothing up there.
One moment. I hope to convince you without this. Batman now has made it impossible. This is no longer under my protection. It was my plan to give you the force repellers free. But now that one of you has doubted me, there will be a charge.
How much, Mr. Trump?
$50 apiece.
Mister, he ain't one of us. We don't even know him. Please.
It's a lot of money, Trump.
It'll go up with every word.
Well, where are your meters?
They will come.
Maybe you're right, but we could die of old age standing around waiting for him.
$75.
Why don't you keep your mouth shut, mister? Nothing is going to happen. The man is a fake, a phony. Can't you see that? He hasn't got any control of meteorites or anything else.
Don't have very many, folks, and they're $75 each.
Don't waste your money. It's a fake. Can't you see that?
Yeah. Haven't you said enough already, mister? Now get out of here before somebody kills you. Here, give me one of those.
The price was high. For many of the people of the town, it was out of all reason. And so they tried to find another way. Pieces of silver and furniture carried from homes in the East were uncovered. Vessels of family pride were polished to be offered in exchange for the force repeller.
Take it easy, folks.
Mister, I ain't got the money. Will you take this? It's worth more than 75.
No, just hard cash. That junk's no good to me. There you go.
Please, mister, please.
No, sir, you get the hard cash, you get the force repeller. Get out of the way, would you, son? There you go.
Sheriff Farrow had seen mob panic before, and always he'd been able to stay out of its way. He didn't intend this time to be any different. He stood quietly and watched the mob grind along the street. He couldn't help but think that Trump had been right. Talpa wouldn't be standing in the morning.
Sheriff, are you still here?
They're breaking into the bank.
What do you want me to do about it?
Well, I don't know, but you can try something.
Look, mister. Maybe you're a hero. I'm not.
All right, Farrah, take off the badge.
Are you telling me what to do?
No, not me. The state of Texas. Now, I'm going to give you 10 seconds to clear this room, and I'm going to start shooting.
We need the money in there.
You're not going to get it.
We got our families to think about.
Tomorrow morning, they won't even look at you. They'll be too ashamed.
Get the banker. He can open the safe.
He can get it open before he gets here.
Stay out of it.
Well, I couldn't shoot at him, and they wouldn't buy the bluff. I just got careless.
Trump's sure having his way. Most of the people in town have got those umbrellas, and he's still got 20 minutes till midnight. And when the town doesn't burn down, who's gonna get the credit?
They had no way of knowing it, but Trump didn't want the credit. He had what he did want. The town's money and a fresh horse. Hobie had been ready to give up. If Talbot didn't want his help, he wasn't going to stand against it. But with the judge's words pushing at him, the ranger decided to have one more try at stopping the entire affair. In order to do it, he had to find the con man before he left town.
Aren't you going to stay for the fireworks? Huh? Looks like you're going to go before everything's done.
I've done all I can for Talbot.
Figure it's time for me to be moving on. Well, I think you ought to wait.
That's where you and I disagree.
You're under arrest, Trump.
What charge?
Well, you write it any way you like. Grand theft, fraud, I think a jury will find it stealing.
How do you expect to prove it?
You and I are going to be right here after midnight.
Ranger? There must be a couple few things that you don't have because maybe they're a little too expensive. I suppose I was to give you, say, a quarter of this. It'd be just about $1,250. Huh? I'll go up to half. $2,500. Man could live almighty good on $2,500 anywhere in the country. $2,500. Just for getting here, say, 15 minutes too late. Help yourself.
I'll take it all, Trump.
Opposite sides of that rope. We could have worked good together.
You're gonna go back and tell him, Trump.
What?
You're gonna go back and tell him it's a fake. That those parasols wouldn't keep him dry in heavy dew.
Oh, not me.
You did a good job working him up into this mood, and now let's see you talk your way out of it.
Give me a break, Ranger.
Like the one you gave the town? Move.
I knew you'd get me out of this.
Sure, that's why you were leaving without telling me.
Well, you don't believe that. I was on my way when the ranger stopped me.
Oh, you were, huh?
You don't think I'd lie, do you?
You don't want an answer to that. No, I don't need you now. Every minute you're alive, my neck's in trouble. And there's a saddlebag.
I'll take it.
ranger. Now it's just you and me. We'll tell him we couldn't find the money.
I know where it is. I know you and Trump are in it together.
Look, you can't prove a thing. Where are you taking me?
Back to Trump's wagon. You're gonna tell the truth.
They'll kill me, sure.
Won't make much difference, will it?
What?
Well, the world's gonna come to an end in 5 minutes.
Hobie took the sheriff back to the mob. He confessed his part in the fraud. There was no way he could deny it. Hobie explained how Trump had set fire to the wagon, a piece of phosphorus that ignited in the temperature of the air. They wanted to believe Gilman, but they still weren't over the hump. He had to find one crack in their fear, one place to start breaking through. Until the crowd knew that everything Trump had said was a lie, there was no hope for Talbot. The confidence man would always get the credit for saving the town. As long as the parasols were up, Trump was still believed.
Hobie, I didn't think you would. Well, it's still standing. You know, watching you talk, looking at them. It was just one thing that bothered me. If you'd have been wrong, I didn't have a parasol.